video, we'll go over how to subtract integers. So first of all, you already have to know how to add integers in order to understand how to subtract them. And first I'm going to go over some methods for subtracting, and then I'm going to show you models, so if you want to understand the reason that these methods work. Okay, so the first thing we need to know is what the opposite of a number is, all right? So the opposite of 3 is negative 3. You simply change signs. So the opposite of negative 2 is positive 2. The opposite of negative 1/2 is positive 1/2. The opposite of 3.9 is negative 3.9, etc. Because we're going to be using the idea of the opposite of a number. All right, here's how we do it. To subtract, you may rewrite the subtraction problem into a corresponding addition problem by doing the following two steps. It doesn't mean you could just change subtraction to addition. There's something you have to do. One, you're going to change the subtraction sign to a plus sign and change the sign of the number after the original number to its opposite. So here's the examples. 2 minus 5. So what it says is what you can do is you can change the minus sign to a plus sign and then take the opposite of the next number. Now, the number after the minus sign is a 5, so we have to write the opposite of 5, which is negative 5. And now this becomes an addition problem. If you want, you can put a parenthesis around here. That's up to you. Now we're adding a positive and a negative, and the negatives outweigh the positive, so it's negative, and the answer then would be 5 minus 2, or 3, negative 3. Here's another one. This is a subtraction problem, 2 minus a negative 5. So what does it say you could do? You could change the minus sign to a plus, right? And then we take what's after the minus sign. This time what's after the minus sign is negative 5. So I'm going to change that to its opposite, which is plus 5. So I have 2 plus 5. All right, that's regular addition with whole numbers, so the answer is 7. This first one was 3. Second one is 7. Okay, let's look at the next one. Negative 2 minus 5. This is very similar to the first example I did over here, except instead of it being 2, it's a negative 2. But you're still going to change that minus sign to a plus, and then you're going to take the opposite of a positive 5, which is going to be a negative 5. And so I've got a negative plus a negative. All right, so I'm going to have a bunch of negatives, right? And 2 plus 5 is 7, so the answer is negative 7. Notice how these look all, they're kind of like all have a 2 or a 5 or a negative 2 or a negative 5, and they're all subtractions, but see, I got different answers because they certainly weren't all the same. Now, you can also think of this as just doing two pencil strokes. Check this out. This is how it would look if you did it in one step without rewriting the problem. This was 2 minus a negative 5. And this one was negative 2 minus 5. Okay, check this out. I'm going to do two things. 1, 2. See what I did? I made two changes. I changed the minus sign to a plus, and I put a minus sign, and then I did something to the next number. So if there was nothing there, I put a minus sign. But check this out. There's two strokes. I changed that to a plus, and then I changed that minus sign to a plus. That makes its opposite. For this third one, I've got same thing. You don't change anything before the minus sign. It's only at the minus sign. You change the minus sign to a plus, and then you put a stroke next to the next number. Now notice that's exactly the same as what I have above here. My previous examples where I wrote out the second step showing what's going on. 2 plus negative 5 is still going to be negative 3 because I'm adding a positive and a negative, and negatives outweigh the positives. 2 plus 5 is still going to be 7. And negative 2 plus negative 5, I'm adding two negatives, so it's negative, and add the 2 and 5 to get negative 7. So that's the two pencil stroke method. I'm going to call that the two, of course it could be a pen or anything else, two pencil stroke. So remember, there's two things you have to do. You have to change the minus sign to a plus and write the opposite of the next number. It's very important you do both. Okay, here's three problems. Try them on your own by rewriting the problem as adding the opposite. You could do it on the same step, or you could take a second step to show the subtraction, depending if you do the two pencil stroke method or not. All right, so if we do write it the second step, take a second step to write this, I changed the minus to a plus, and now I have to take the opposite of 8, which is negative 8, and now I'm adding two negatives. So there's going to be negative, and I add 27 and 8, which is negative 35. Next one. Remember, I don't ever change the number in front of the minus sign. So I just write the 14. I'm changing minus sign to a plus. And I take the opposite of positive 19, which is negative 19. Whether or not you put that in parentheses is up to you. Notice I did here for the negative 8. I'm leaving it off to show you it's okay to also write it this way. Now you're writing a positive and negative, so the negatives outweigh the other. And so I have 19 minus 14. That's going to be negative 5. You could also think of this as like you got $14 in your account. You write a check for $19, you're in the hole, $5. Okay, let's do this other one. You write the first number down, change subtraction to addition, and what's the opposite of negative 11? Positive 11. So that would be negative 8 plus 11. You're adding a negative and a positive. There's more positives. So the answer is positive, and 11 minus 8 is 3. All right, let's do the two pencil stroke method. So same exact problems. With two pencil strokes, I'm going to go plus a negative, plus a negative, plus a positive. And now I do the same thing. I'm going to get the same exact answers. Negative 35, negative 5, and positive 3. Okay, why does this work? Why is it that subtracting 3, for instance, should be the same thing as adding negative 3? So let's look at this example. This is just an example. If I have negative 2 minus 3, you could think of this as, well, I'm starting out with a negative 2, so you're starting with two negatives, and you're going to take away, right, minus, usually means take away 3. Well, that would mean 3 positives. Well, what would that look like? I'm going to start with two negatives. And it says, now take away 3 positives. There aren't any positives in there to take away. But remember, another way of writing negative 2 is to have some extra negatives and extra positives, so you still have two extra negatives when you're looking at the whole thing. So notice what it looks like if I wrote negative 2 this way. And now I'm going to do my taking away thing here. I'm going to take away 3 positives. So I'm going to remove these, okay? I'm going to remove those. What did I end up with for my answer? My answer, well, I have this, and I have 3 more negatives. What happened? I got the answer by starting out with 2 negatives and adding to it 3 more negatives. So instead of subtracting 3 positives, my answer ended up being the same as if I just added 3 negatives. So the answer would be negative 5. So I could just simply write negative 2 plus negative 3 to get negative 5. That's a little representation using these sort of positive and negative counters, if you will. Here's one more example, 2 minus 6. Well, that would mean, you know, what are the numbers? Positive 2 minus positive 6. You could think of this as you're going to start off with 2 positives and try to remove 6 positives. But you only have 2 positives. So one way of making sure you have enough is just go ahead and put in 6 of each, right? 3, 4, 5, 6, and also put in 6 negatives. So this still is just the number positive 2 because I have those 2 extra positives hanging out there. And now, by writing 2 this way, can I remove 6 positives? Sure. I'm going to remove those 6 positives. So what's the net effect? It looks like I had two positives and I ended up with six more negatives, which is the number negative 4, right? So I got the answer by starting off with two positives. Instead of removing six positives, look, I got the same answer as if I just went ahead and added six negatives. And there you go. 2 minus 6 is 2 plus negative 6, which is negative 4. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.